Thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Adam Sexton. Here's a look at the stories we're following this afternoon. An historic moment this morning in D.C. as the Pope spoke before Congress. Many Granite Staters made the pilgrimage to see the Pope in person. However, some of those who couldn't make the trip assembled for watch parties here at home. WMUR's Ray Brewer has the story.
There has been a lot of talk of how this Pope has energized people. That was evident here in Concord among those who gathered to hear him speak.
Sustain the life of society.
I've heard people say over and over again, what a breath of fresh air.
An overflow crowd filled the Red River theaters to hear the Pope's historic address to Congress. The viewing party sponsored by the New Hampshire Council of Churches and the League of Conservation Voters, excited about the fact that the Pope is talking about the environment.
It brings an aspect of moral authority to the issue of climate change and climate change action. Having the Pope here in the United States bringing focus and talking about these issues is an enormously joyful experience.
While the Pope is the leader of the world's Roman Catholics, practitioners of other faiths say he brings a message that is important for all to hear.
Particularly this Pope, who's been so humble and really been a great example of what faith in the public life can be.
Another aspect that people have remarked on in addition to humility is that the Pope seems to be a man of the people, even down to the car he rides in.
I think people are just pleased with his demeanor, the way he presents himself. He lives a very humble life, and he has been, and I think he's calling us all to live more simply, so that others may simply live.
We all come from similar spiritual places where we're trying to reach the same similar spiritual goals in our lives.
The challenge now amongst those who attended, they say, will be to put the Pope's words into action. In Concord, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.
Our coverage of Pope Francis's visit continues 24 hours a day right here on WMUR.com. You'll find a slideshow of photos from his historic trip to the United States, along with the full text of today's speech. This afternoon, a serious crash in Epping is under investigation. Earlier today, police were called to Route 125, just north of Route 27, for a motorcycle crash. The operator of that motorcycle has been identified as 62-year-old Richard Wall of Epping. He was med-flighted to a Boston hospital with serious injuries. Anyone who witnessed this crash is asked to call police. Manchester police were busy overnight. Officers responded to at least half a dozen drug overdoses. At this point, none of the cases are fatal, but officers were called to the same building twice, and police say the last couple of weeks have been exceptionally busy with overdose calls. Emergency officials say there have now been more than 500 overdoses with 65 deaths. Police need your help finding a man accused of trying to steal from a Concord Sears store who made quite a scene. Take a look at your screen. Police say the man allegedly put several drills in his cart and then tried to leave the store. When employees attempted to stop him, he made chicken noises and ran out of the store. He's described as being between the ages of 25 and 35 years old. He's white, wearing a black long-sleeve shirt with jeans or possibly sweatpants and flip-flop style shoes. Starting tonight at 5, new numbers in the presidential primary show outsiders still going strong in the Granite State. And Chris Brown may have to cancel his Australia tour. His criminal record may mean he's not allowed in that country. That does it for us. I'm Adam Sexton. Have a great afternoon.